Harvard-trained researcher Shanti Feldhahn decided to tackle long-held beliefs about divorce to hopefully right some wrongs. She says just the idea that it's as bad in the church as the rest of the world can demoralize Christians.
For a pastor, it means all my work doesn't mean very much. You know, for the average person in a congregation, there's this subtle feeling like, if that's true, if on something as important as marriage, doing what the Bible says doesn't change anything, what does that mean about the Bible?
Virginia pastor Daniel Floyd sees how this can hurt the faith.
Because the 50% divorce rate inside the church really just said the church makes no difference in your marriage. And that's quite an indictment on the church.
Christian psychotherapist Angel Davis says the belief half of all marriages fail can even give people permission to give up.
When you have like a statistic like 50%, it gives you the option. It's like becomes an option in your mind.
Feldhahn spent 8 years investigating the real numbers, and in her book, The Good News About Marriage, lays out what she found. First, the divorce rate is way below 50% and much lower for those who attend church. Feldhahn estimates the overall divorce rate for the country is around 31%. And she says the studies of people who regularly go to church all show a much lower divorce rate for them.
Maybe 15%, maybe 20% for all marriages. First marriages, second marriages, third marriages. Pastors need to know this. People need to be able to look around the average congregation and say, you know what? Most of these people will have strong and happy marriages for a lifetime. Doing what God says matters. That is a big deal to know.
Feldhahn cites one example where a pastor tracked 143 couples who he had married.
It was 25, 27 years later, less than 10% had been divorced.
Therapist Davis says this could go a long way to erasing the doubt that Christianity makes no difference.
That there's no power in it to transform. And that is just not true. So those statistics, I think, could help a lot with that belief.
Pastor Floyd believes it'll be a major plus for the faith when this new knowledge gets around.
But if you have regular church attendance, then it's going to make a difference in the longevity of your marriage. I think that is incredible firepower, so to speak, for the local church, for the pastor.
Feldhahn says she's seen the power of this new information when she shares it to immediately pump up a congregation's faith.
You hear this gasp go through the congregation because it's, and everybody starts applauding, and it's like you can see hope coming back into their eyes.
Shanti's husband Jeff says such hope can be crucial in helping a couple actually survive.
I mean, Shanti and I have had tough patches, but we never once thought that we weren't going to make it. We knew we were going to. So you work through the tough patches and you move on to the other side, and the other side is always good.
Feldhahn says people can make other choices to divorce-proof their marriage. An example?
People who decide not to live together before they get married. That has been proven to have a really good effect on the marriage. And so you might get down into the 5-10% divorce odds.
Now Feldhahn and others hope people will spread the word.
To be able to get this information into other people's hands quickly, I really think we can change the paradigm from discouragement to hope.
Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Atlanta.